that was awesome. We had three, you know, in most matches, you know, and
they
did
a good job. Yeah, you got to give a shout out to, just in terms of the VAWA stuff. What's the guy's name that's
been attending? Pearson. Yeah.
You got to give a shout out to Tim Pearson.
He's everywhere.
But he's been doing a great job at disseminating the information on what the what the people need.
Did you say disseminating?
He's a UVA guy.
Somebody's been through the thesaurus.
No, but you got to give that guy a shout out. He's been he's been on it.
Oh, Pearson's been great.
He's a good dude too.
Yeah. He went down to Brazil for the Fila Cadet
fans,
and was going for his Fila too. And usually, you know, when guys get that officiating game and they're trying to get their Fila license, they tend to be a little bit younger. You know, Tim was officiating, then he got out of it, and now he got back into it. He's one of the finest officials around. And he's such a cool guy. What, your phone's ringing too? It's his mom. He's wishing you a good Shabbos.
Ah, good Shabbos. We got some brisket waiting for you at home. Did you like the candles
yet? The dad's a Jewish.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah.
She can do a good imitation of brisket.
Yeah.
The
mom. This is what we do like at every tournament. I mean, they're cracking backs, or Ross and I are
cracking backs.
Cracking jokes about
good job out there.
But, we'll get to the court.
Overall, repping was a lot better. I mean, they did. I mean, of course, Coach Roy Hill, his boys, man.
Roy Hill,
you know, those kids were scrapped.
I asked him when he's coming down. I'm
doing a good job with it, man.
Yeah.
And then other stuff we got, you know, next Southeast Regional props. Colonial Forge brought a bunch of kids down there. Pete Redder brought a bunch of kids down there. Banditos brought a bunch of kids down there. Virginia had a lot of success, man. You know, a little bit more than the year before, but a good amount of success. What's so funny? What?
It's a little Ross.
Oh.
That was literally 10 years ago.
That was last week, really.
Yeah, he aged.
What did you say that was?
He was like, you're
like, is that Jersey Shore?
Yeah. Okay, this is, they're like, what are they looking at? This is Ross's Facebook page, and you know, you have the little big picture, and it's Baby Ross.
Still has to be seen the hairline.
Yeah.
And he's looking out like, where were you, Italy or something?
France.
Oh, all right, so he's on this beach resort in beautiful coastline of France.
Oh, it's the freaking Eiffel Tower.
It's Paris.
Whatever. Anyway. And I sent him a comment like, what are you, the Jersey Shore looking out the boardwalk?
Snuggy.
D-tem-wah.
You know, but Southeast Regionals was good, so, you know, had a lot of success with VAWA. I'm bringing it back on top, boys. You know,
bringing it back.
DuPont placed in Greco, took a third. Yeah. Didn't have a great freestyle showing, but, you know, went down there, meddled in Greco.
It shows you the depth of that league.
How about a shout out to Colin Girardi?
Oh, yeah, man.
Yeah, we went up 113.
Winning both styles. And there was a couple of Virginia boys in that way. Jackson Gray was in that way. And also had Little Saunders from Johnson Wrestling Club.
Yeah.
I haven't forgotten the first name, but, you know, you had a bunch of champs on the schoolboy level, you know, with Manvilles and all those boys, and then Trent Ragland, you know. So, Southeast Regionals, VAWA was pretty represented. And then Field Cadet Props, we'll let you all take over that. Ross was out there.
Yeah, we went out. I just went out with Joey Prada. Did a good job.
He did a great job.
Made to the finals and crossed to Spencer Lee. And
that was face smasher in that by Lee. I didn't like that.
Had a hard time keeping him off his head, but but there's stuff to be worked on. And beat some good kids. He fell from Oklahoma.
What a great run, man. How was that true second match, though?
That's a tough match. You're in the finals, and then you got to rush for true second, especially against a guy who's coming on strong.
I guess the Jews if you want the match, right?
Yeah, Ben Freeman's the guy from Michigan.
He's pretty tough.
He's had some wars with before, and you know, we had a hard time keeping him off our right leg. It was lefty sweep all day, so just stuff to work on. But it's a good tournament. You know, that's actually something for VAWA that I want to talk to Swing about. Just that feel of that tournament's awesome. And it's tough because it coincides with the Southeast Regional tournament. You can get more and more guys to do it today. It's a great tournament.
I know Strickland was talking about it. I've noticed a lot of people are going to Northeast Region.
I think it's
going to
be
going to the Cadets, maybe.
the problem is we're, as a state, I think we're sanctioned in Southeast.
That's like our qualifier. Yeah.
But it's all good. I mean, the kids are wrestling as they want.
Get them out there.
I mean, next topic I got written down.
Guns out.
Yeah, they're out.
Well, let's talk about.
I'm surprised they let me in the restaurant.
Well, Boss, if you're gonna wear that shirt, buddy, you gotta go outside and get
a little. I did. I'm a little
uncomfortable. Oh yeah, and by the way, for the third week in a row, we are at the Third Street Diner in beautiful downtown Richmond, Virginia. Ross didn't know this place existed.
Yes.
But
it's a great place.
I didn't get him out of his comfort zone.
You're looking for good breakfast food, right?
Yeah.
Come on in.
Yeah. I'll head down there. I'll get a server's name here in a little bit, you know, and we'll give him a little shout out. We got different service tonight.
Yeah.
A little nice and monkey there, right? Let's go coaching moves.
Coaching moves.
We'll start off with West Virginia. I'm going to be honest. If you go back and listen to our podcast on that, who called it, boys?
Yeah, I know.
Sammy Henson got the job. I want to thank Coach Swink for giving me the finalists last week when we were down here eating dinner with Coach Swink. That was all. But, Sammy Henson getting that job. I read something that he's been at like 8 different schools in the last like 12 years or whatever, you know, something like that. But, that's a gold mine, if you can, you know. And he's benefited every program he's been at.
Sammy's a good guy.
That's good.
He's one of the most intense and physical guys I've ever seen. I mean, he and I grew up wrestling at the same time. Never got to wrestle him.
Pennsylvania?
No, he's from Missouri. Okay. And I'm kind of glad I didn't wrestle him because he wrestled one of my teammates in the Junior National Greco.
Goodbye, that's the Sherman State.
He got freaking tooled. I mean, Sammy was lifting and throwing this guy like he was a rag doll. I mean, Sammy was a really good Greco wrestler before he became a really, really good freestyle wrestler. So I'm hoping that, at West Virginia that they pick up the slack, and I think it's a good thing. It's good for the sport.
Oh yeah,
it's good for the sport.
Purdue just got a new coach. Ursuline got the job. Ursuline's been assistant coach, I think, at
Iowa, Nebraska.
Yeah, he's been at Nebraska though. I mean, that's good. He's sticking in the Big Ten. Purdue's
what happened to the Nebraska coach? I didn't know.
No. Ursuline got South Purdue.
Yeah. Oh, Purdue. I'm sorry. Yeah.
So Ursuline's gonna do. I mean, that's still like Indiana. Still a hotbed of wrestling still out there with Illinois.
Good academic school. Good engineering school. And now what we've got? Penn and which Michigan?
Eastern Michigan.
Eastern Michigan. Limestone College opened up.
Let's talk about one last time before we get on to that. Donnie Kritzloff getting, hired as a, associate head coach at Rutgers.
How do you feel about that, Tamer?
Sorry, Donnie's a legend in Lyndhurst, New Jersey. I grew up idolizing him.
He's a hometown guy.
He's a hometown.
Bring it back.
Hometown icon. He grew up the whole, Swoop single New Jersey, to be honest. He's awesome. And you saw it, Goodbody, you were talking about it with Ashland, watching him in Ohio, being Circe's, and then he beat what's his name from Oregon State, the final.
Oh, Mangrum.
He beat Circe's. Version,
Mangrum. Random Boston.
How did he beat Circe's?
Big hire.
They needed something to spark. Yeah. I thought it was going to be with Corey Cooper a couple years ago.
Corey getting it going.
Yeah.
I like Scott Goodale. I like what he did when he was Jackson Memorial.
Great guy.
Good. Yeah, he's another guy I grew up wrestling with. He was in the Seagull Club way back in the day.
DiBiase.
Yep. And on the AAU and then the USA Wrestling. He used to wrestle with
Vern Archer, Vern
Zellner.
Did you ever sit on his lap between periods? Called you over.
I bet Ross sat on his lap.
Come on in.
In between periods?
No, I didn't. He was a big Greco guy. Because I never did Greco.
That's what Peter said.
Yeah, Ross sat on his lap.
I've been interested. I've known Vern, again, I've known Vern a long time.
That guy's a legend, man.
Yeah, he's a great guy. Still in contact with him. He'll be out in Fargo, and he's one of those guys that's been around forever because he loves the sport. He likes working with kids and putting out with the kids. So,
But yeah, I think Kritloff and Rutgers, I think it's just a great fit, man. I'm looking forward to it. It's good seeing those Jersey guys that had a lot of success. You know, the Bukes at Princeton.
I'm looking forward to seeing Ashton wrestling next year.
Oh yeah, he's going 41, which is, you know, that's going right after, you know, Logan, going right after Steven, you know, so that's intriguing, but he's going to do it, and it's going to be a good flash 41 battle.
You know, Rutgers had the first All-American in a long time over, you know, this past year.
Barati.
So that's huge for the program, and it's just going to keep going up and up and up for Rutgers. You know, Kritloff and Goodale, man, they're going to get it going.
Yeah, man. Let's talk about Eider leaving Penn. I mean, that's a good job, man. You can't beat that education.
I know.
And, you know, it's hopping to wrestling. So Pennsylvania, New Jersey.
You think they're going to cut it?
No. No, not a chance.
I mean, I don't think, because that was kind of like one of those things going around, like new AD and then your head wrestling coach resigns.
I think Eider had a...
This is not good, right?
So it's, I think family stuff. I think he wanted to kind of take a step back.
Right.
You know, I know talking to Matt Lindy this past weekend, you know, he obviously wants it, but kind of what you were saying, it's a big commodity. It's a high commodity right now. People are going to be going for it, which is a good thing.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, that's a big time job.
You're in a good place there.
Not a good neighborhood, but it's a good university.
A lot of good recruits available there. Pennsylvania, New Jersey, New York.
Burizelli from
Ohio State.
Awesome. He's a guy that I think is a name that might be going around for a good job.
They were throwing his name around for the freestyle job, the WBU job, the freestyle job that...
All the little articles I've been reading with him. It says it seems like he's gonna stay at Ohio State. They got their team's gonna
be Ohio right now.
Their team's gonna be good this year.
They're content with it.
I would want to stick around there. We talked about that in the previous podcast.
So Roselli's gonna stay around, and I think in 2016 maybe, you know, with the U.S. job, you know, for that's ready to get somebody step in there. Yeah. Maybe, you know, maybe 2020 Roselli. I think he's gonna stick with Ohio State.
It's a good program for him. You know, again, they're gonna contend for the NCAA championship.
Why
would you want to? I mean, I understand wanting to be a head coach, but when you're in a program that's gonna bring home that title,
how would he do it at Michigan Directional School?
East of Michigan, he's not taking over.
Who's taking over that?
Who's taking over that?
Taking over East of Michigan.
Hey guys, I'm in Michigan.
Nikki Alley, if you're watching, sorry.
It's really cold out here.
He's used to that cold weather.
He's from Michigan. I mean, that's the type of job that you just don't know who's going to take it. They've done better. They had a lot of good academic success. With academic.
I'll throw her name, Alex Hunter. Would love to see him get a
coaching
job.
Yeah.
Leave UVA. Yeah, right? Big loss for UVA.
Yeah,
oh, it definitely lost, but yeah. Alex wants to be head coach.
And
you do a good
job. I think
you
do a good job.
You
did a good leader.
He
sounded
more and more like
a
good leader.
Yeah.
Put it in the books.
Next thing I got written down, World Team Trials, man. World Team Trials. Exciting weekend of wrestling.
Well, they're only doing the Olympic weight classes in this cycle.
Yes, it's only freestyle previous.
I know. And where are they doing the Greco World Team Trials?
Cadet Duels.
Will Ross be there watching? Mm-hmm.
Probably. No, Tommy Owens said they got a guy coming down, heavyweight.
Oh, wrestle Kettler?
That's good.
Patriot Elite up there with Tommy Owens and all that, man. Seheed and all those boys doing freestyle Greco.
A lot of Northern VA guys. A lot of Northern Region guys.
Seheed has a tough first round, though. Feel it.
Who's he at?
He has either like Ashton. I think he has Ashton first or that.
That is bad.
Or maybe, or Ashton or Pico.
Either one, yeah.
Yeah.
No.
The Pico's way from Ashton.
I think I'd rather wrestle Ashton than Pico.
Pico's coming off a couple losses, though.
Yeah. And you know, that's kind of funny that you mentioned that. You know, like.
Look at the break.
The kid loses to, you know, a tough Russian guy, whatever. People are like, oh no, maybe he made a bad choice. You know, it's wrestling. You're gonna win, you're gonna lose. You know, maybe I think it's good, you know, he's not You know, he's not Superman. He's not invincible.
I think that kid was also like second on the the ladder.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, and people don't realize that. Like, kid loses one match and they think that he's, oh, he made a mistake. Oh, no, he's screwed.
You gotta look who he lost to.
Yeah,
the bad loss is a good loss.
And, you know, we talked about message boards a while ago, and most of the people that are on message boards are generally uninformed know-it-alls.
So, I know ODU sent a lot of kids out the field of juniors. You know, Kevin Beasley's obviously trying to make the world team in Greco.
In Greco, which is unusual for ODU.
You know, Brandon Jeske's going out there and he's going to wrestle. Wrestling a little bit heavier than I would think he should.
He had 30.
He's at the same, like 60-something kilos.
30-32.
Yeah.
2.2, good body.
McKenna's at that weight too, so.
That'd be interesting to see McKenna and Jeske wrestle.
Yeah, they're on the opposite side of the bracket numbers. So.
Yeah.
But, you know, and then Lenny Richardson and Jersey Boy, you know,
I think looking at the results, Jesse got injured.
Did he really? I haven't looked at any results today for that tournament, so.
Yeah.
You know, I was doing SOL stuff, you know.
SOL?
Yeah.
Yeah? He does actual schoolwork there.
Yeah, I'm like, Ross, take this. He just gets to watch the
national wrestling.
Hey, he's a math teacher, man. He's an academic dude. He's not like me. He's not a PE teacher.
Algebra and geometry.
Yeah.
Field of Juniors, I mean, you got tons of loaded weight. You know, Kyle Snyder.
He's so much fun to watch.
That's gonna be fun.
Merlin.
You know, you got course to Ashnault, Pico, Zane Rutherford weight class. I mean, that's gonna be exciting.
That's lame. Where's Rutherford from?
Benton. Well, Pine Mountain, but then he transferred to Benton. Had to sit out a year because the PIA just said that he moved.
It was a questionable move.
Yeah, and they ruled him ineligible, so he sat out a year.
The crazy thing about the World Team Trials, though, is I read something where, like, they said 57 kilograms in the United States a week at the tournament.
Right.
You look at that weight class, it is loaded.
Who's in it?
I mean, McDonough just made the cut down.
Yeah.
You know, and you still have Escobedo, you know, Hayes Winkle's there waiting. You have Hans Stresser. You know, like, that weight. A Ramos was wrestling in that weight class. I mean, Tony hasn't obviously had much freestyle experience right now.
Right.
But that weight class is lovely.
Ramos is just a goer, you know? And I don't know if that's going to translate to good freestyle right now. But I think, you know, if he works with Metcalf, he's going to be solid.
Yeah.
What are you, waitress? John, good body, sir, probably. But anyway, what's the next topic?
The next topic is the mixed room. At the end of Freestyle Greco, trying to mix up Coke and Greco.
Right.
And, trying to appease all that women.
Yeah, last night was an interesting practice at New Kent, because we had a lot of young.
We had 9 middle schoolers. About 8 of which have ever,
And it's the same, you know, St. Chris. I mean, we're going to have guys that are going to be focusing on freestyle, a couple guys, you know, freestyle Greco, and then everybody else with freestyle.
No, it's a great topic, because especially when you're trying to build a program, you're trying to make it from good to really good, or
right.
Not good to just sort of good. How do you make that transition with kids that want to go to a high level and kids that are just kind of learning the sport?
Right.
Yeah.
So it's hard.
Yeah.
And also, you know, you're happy these kids are coming out there in the spring. You're not. You know, we have kids that like Mr. Baseball Game come and train, or, you know, Mr. One come to get left, or get on the mat. You know, so, and I can tell their frustration because, I just went through my first season of folk style, and now you're showing me a different style.
It's like, I had no idea what's going on.
Frustration.
Yeah.
You know, they came to me and said, I don't think I like this. I was like, well, you really haven't looked at this stuff. Why, how can you base it on one practice? You can't.
And last night, those guys were probably like,
it's previous practice. So like,
it was like a Gordon polish day. I went through the drill list, and it was like polish day.
Nothing wrong with that.
No, but the young guys were just kind of like learning things. You know, we had like 6 or 7 guys that had been in the room all spring, so they're going through the technique.
Yeah, and then you had some just hot newcomers.
Coach, what do I do here? Where do I put my hands? So, you know, really.
And they were asking questions that I was happy about. They were, you know.
That's why you guys have such a good program, is that, you know, you get 30 guys in your practice room.
And, yeah.
You know, that's awesome.
But like, that's a problem that you face now, is, you know, yeah, one guy going over here, he's going to go to Indianapolis for the schoolboy duels. Then we have a bunch going to Lycoming, that it's a folk style event, you know, and then you have some people going to Fargo,
yeah.
so it's a diverse room right now.
And, you know, we'll put heads together and get guys in the right places, you know. And BC, LeBrade, you know, he works out with Predator, with you guys, and hopefully we can get him in our room for a while and work out with some of our guys, and, you know, it's just getting different looks and just working out with different people, you know.
And I think where we're going to go next year is I think we're going to do even less folk style. I think our focus will be freestyle Greco for even longer, even until the school's out, and then maybe like in July, we'll bring in a clinician in to work folk style or something like that.
Right.
We probably won't go to Lycoming. And we'll bring in, you know, if I know a guy that used to wrestle the UVA, and you haven't been to our room to see your old picture. We have it up there.
Yeah, I mean, you look like a young, spry lad.
Yes.
You look angry.
Yes.
You were bald.
Yeah, you were bald. You were bald.
Yeah, that's what I'm bald.
I'll tell you.
When you wrestle Fortune.
Yeah.
Talk about that all the time.
That was a good match. I gotta get over to
Newcastle.
I can
drive you over.
Yeah.
You get lost.
Yeah.
But
what's going on here?
I don't know, like, mixed room, I mean, it's tricky. Like, what do y'all think? Like, it's hard to do, but you gotta do it. Like,
you gotta somehow make it so that the kids know why everything is gonna make you better.
Yeah.
Right. Like, you can't do something and just say, well, this is pointless. You know, just make it purposeful. And I think Greco freestyle, elastic, everything can work together.
What I'm doing right now, we have all the kids on board, and they did a good job last night with it. They did a good job on Tuesday with it. I have the kids being flexible. Like, hey, you know, I know some of you have to train at the camp, but when you're going with, you know, Trent, when you're going with BC, when you're, you know, when they need your help freestyle Greco-wise, you're making that transition, helping them out.
Yeah.
And so the kids are, you know, they know that they got to be good teammates, they got to be flexible. That, you know, it's not just about them as an individual, it's also about the team a little bit too. So that's how we're handling the mixed room. When I first got to New Camp, we kind of did it a little bit differently, but right now it's working well. I'm like, it's tough to do. I don't like doing it. I wish we could have stayed on, you know, the international styles right now, but for camp purposes, those kids got to be ready for all this tough Jersey and PA and New York boys.
I talked about what we might change up this year, because let's get a freestyle and record a little later.
Yeah, we forgot to mention about coaching changes. You know, of course, we forgot Greco.
Oh, yeah, awesome. Oh.
Guys forgot Greco.
Oh, where's that guy going?
Yeah, you hear Greco, he's running.
No, fast.
Good luck with that.
I also, real quick, get one of the ladies' names. Let's do a shout out to the new girl, Tina.
Tina?
Just, you know, getting trained down there.
Short girl.
No, that's Amanda.
Tina has the Philippians.
We're at Third Street Diner here in Richmond, Virginia.
She's getting trained
doing
well.
Doing a shout out to Tina, doing a great job.
And you know,
Amanda, doing a great thing.
Great Boston song, by the way. I'm going to take you by surprise and make you realize.
Nah, not a fan of it, no.
Good song.
No, Thursday, no.
I'm going to tell you right away, I can't wait another day. Amanda, that's another good one.
You know, we always be great service. We have 33 dollars.
I don't know if they like what we're doing, but they
I don't know if they understand what we're doing.
Yeah, they kind of adopted us. Oh, yeah. Moved in.
Yeah.
We're like squatters.
Yeah.
That's, I mean, you know, it's open 24 hours a day, and again, it's.
There's nobody sitting up here.
No.
So they figure.
I'm probably the first F-bomb
F-bomb drop.
Walking around.
apologize to everybody.
And it comes from, like, the midnight guy. I would have figured it would have been either you or me. Or this guy.
Well, Luigi over there, you know, he has a lot of he had to do some plumbing and stuff.
He had to do some plumbing.
That was quick. How'd you find it?
Came up the tube. All right, but let's talk about Greco's position.
Yeah, let's talk about Matt Leahy.
I had it written down, man.
Yeah, I know.
It was written down.
Well, it was all.
But then I got really excited. It was starred out here.
Well, yeah, but
it's outside the margin.
Well, with Pritzloff getting the job at Rutgers, that's huge.
I got a little excited.
Yeah, that's cool because you're a Jersey guy, you know. It's...
It was left off originally. Thank you, Ross, for pointing that out. Make sure I have that on there. But Greco, Matt Lindland.
Matt Lindland.
Is he? We talked about this.
I apologize.
We did not throw his
650738.
We did not throw Matt Lindland's name out there.
No, you know, and
it makes sense.
But the reason why I didn't throw his name in there was the guy's been in mixed martial arts for the past 10 years.
But he also has been doing a lot of those tournaments. Like he goes with the World, he went to the World Cup.
Yeah, you know, I think it's great. You know, if he's all in, and I hope he's all in, and I hope he gets to work with him next month. You know, he's an Olympic silver medalist, the world silver medalist at a higher weight class next year. Obviously, he knows the sport. I just hope that he's all in. You know, that's the thing that I hope Bruce Burnett with freestyle is all in. We're at a crossroads with freestyle and Greco on the senior and level. You know, because we're not doing as well as we should.
See, when the Ultimate Fighter was that coming out, UFC was like starting to like boom. I was already a fan. I watched like Lindland fight. It was like when GSP, same pay-per-view, GSP fought Mayhem Miller. It was a long time ago. Somebody looked that up. That's a long time ago.
Mayhem Miller?
Yeah, GSP fought Mayhem Miller and it beat the dog out of him. But Lindland hit an arm throw and it was dirty.
Dirty arm throw?
Oh yeah, it was dirty.
I mean, I'm excited. I hope he's out at the training camp that I'm going to next month. And I want to work. I want to pick his brain.
How old is he?
He's probably my age, Mike's age, maybe a year.
38, 39.
Might be within like 2 or 3 years. But it seems like he's, you know, with the MMA stuff. No, I don't know who you are.
We don't know who you are.
Yeah, you gotta let us know.
Tell us.
Put your name on it.
See, Ross fits in naturally. You know, next week he's just gonna show right up. Hey, here for the show.
Yeah,
you know
what
I'm saying.
You know, like Greco though, like I read a cool article and it was in New Wind magazine talking about the different like having the World Team trials on different days.
Yeah.
And it was talking about how it gives Greco guys the opportunity to compete in those styles.
Yeah.
And also gives those freestyle guys the opportunity to be like, hey, maybe I can make the world team in Greco.
It used to be, you
and
know,
it's going
to
be a good crossover.
In the 70s, and it's going way back, but you know, you'd have guys wrestling both styles at the trials. Even some in the Olympics wrestling both styles.
Crazy.
Yeah. So.
That's wild. But Matt Lindland, that's an awesome. I think it's good for our country. It's something different.
It's good for the sport.
You know, he said he's, you know, in an interview, he said he was pretty, you know, pretty close with Frazier.
Yeah.
And I'll
say.
I knew it was coming. But so Greco, I mean, hopefully, like we had talked about, the Minnesota Storm guys and all this stuff.
I think Chris Mike was watching.
No, you're the man, Chris.
Oh wait,
we missed it, Chris.
You know who we didn't acknowledge that was at Freestyle States?
Who was that?
Oh,
Matt Keel.
Choose top.
Matt Keel, choose top.
Who says he hasn't watched the program?
The Skyline Coach.
We give you an homage
every week.
ChooseTop.com.
Top, buddy.
So guess what? Oh, it's probably Chris Michael or Jeff Gregory.
So I'm guessing Chris Michael.
Is the mystery guest, yeah.
Great people are here on Talking Wrestling.
Great
I'm glad we finally got Ross.
The biggest school bags are the three of us. And then we're just
I
want to
get thousands of viewers.
You might step it up.
Yeah. Like,
if we put Ross Katoma on this, people will be like, man, I want to watch that.
Well,
it's Jeff Gregory. Or no, it's either that or Swink. It could be Swink.
I'd be cool if it's Swink. Swink could come down again.
Yeah.
Swink committed for once a month.
Once a month.
When's June? June Swink.
It's
stuff coming up that you guys got going on the rest of the community. Ross, what do you got coming up, man? What do you got going on the rest of the community? Got some clinics, you got anything going on?
This weekend, actually, we're going and doing a clinic on Sunday at James River High School.
James River High School.
Zach Anderson, give a shout out to him. He's my former teammate and roommate at UVA. And
One year,
we went to the other street. Good guy. Next week. Yeah, not much. Just training now. Got guys
over
to that
duel.
What are we doing our
part,
though? Rob and I are doing a camp on June 16th
to
the
19th. No, St. Chris.
That's St. Chris?
St. Christopher's Elite Camp.
I might just stop up and like stop in like heck we got.
Yeah, like where's two tool bags?
That's cool though, Primus. What you got going on, man?
Let me tell you, Dave, guys.
I'm gonna tell you something.
I am gonna be so busy over the next month and a half.
You are busy bee.
Tomorrow I'm going up to Robinson to do the schoolboy mini camp. Then next Saturday after medical graduation, I'm going up to Hanover Hawkeye to do the duels mini camp. Doing the camp with Ross. Let's see, I've got junior duels with Sonny. Then at the beginning of July, I go out to the Olympic Training Center for the Field Cadet World Team Camp. I'm missing Fargo training camp. Sorry, Bill. You know what I'm talking about. Then I go right from training camp to Slovakia, then directly to Fargo.
So, busy, man.
Yeah, what about you, Foss?
What do I have coming up?
What do you have coming up?
Well, we have a bachelor party tomorrow night.
We're two wrestling coaches. Yeah. Chris Steinbacher is getting married June 21st.
Sorry, girls, they're taken now.
Coach Jesse Bell from Manchester, he's getting married. My brother and his wedding, that's June 28th. They're doing their bachelor party tomorrow. It's going to be a good old time.
I might make it to that.
You know, Primus, you're going to hobble in.
You're going to hobble your tail in with one pin.
I know.
It's bad. We just have the pools open out there at Avalon.
Are you going to Lycoming?
Going to Lycoming at the end of the night. Fun time.
By yourself, you're going there.
Well, there's 13 kids going.
Yeah, there's kids going.
But no coaches.
No, it's you. I'm not even going to go that way.
He gets to hang out.
By the way, did you hand to
an Avalon jersey?
No, Avalon on the West End is...
He was getting excited. Is that up or down the shore?
Down the shore.
Avalon, it's South Ocean City, right? Yeah. Love Ocean City. Yeah,
it's a little north there.
By the way, Japan joins in the background. Great, great thing.
No Pearl Jam.
They are no
You'd love Eddie better, man.
Freaking love
him. He is Eddie. He wait, no.
One of our alumni comes and helps us out now. Great kid, Brett Flora. He loves
Shout
Florida
out.
Too, man.
Brett Flora coming in the new kid, man. Talked to him last night.
He's a good kid.
He's a great kid. He was, what, a 2- or 3-time medalist for you?
Yeah, state finalist for us.
State finalist last year. Great kid.
Second and third.
Yeah, comes in and just.
First year was eighth grader.
Yeah.
Picked it up, worked a lot.
Good old country kid. Love the kid. He's just an awesome kid. Good family.
Yeah.
What are you doing, good buddy?
Coming up wrestling wise, I mean, I'm gonna probably stop in and support the community James River clinics. You know, because Josh is my boy, Zach's my boy. You're gonna be out there. Might as well stop
You're
in
my boy,
just to support. And then you got Kurt Jones doing one of those James River clinics. I'm gonna stop in at that. Other than that, I mean, just you know, training. Hopefully, we'll be at y'all's place on Tuesday.
Oh yeah.
You know, we're going.
Somehow we'll have to sneak in there without Gordon realizing.
Talk about that too. Like, I mean,
Gordon popping. What are these guys all doing here?
Hey, what are these guys?
You know,
what's Foss doing
that's
here?
That's a good crossover, though, man.
It's gonna make both
our programs, both of our programs better. You know, because I mean, my kids here, we talk all the time.
You get sick of talking all the time.
You know, get Ross in there a little bit, man. It's gonna make my kids better, and it's gonna make y'all's kids a little better.
He did wear a singlet.
Strapped up?
Yeah, he strapped up.
I went hard.
You belted it.
It was the 1990 World Cup, or John Smith singlet.
It's creative. Yeah.
I got an old school medium. Old school medium.
I got early
low cut Virginia singlet. thing early. It was before the start. It just said Virginia, like B down near the cross.
Yeah.
That's good stuff.
Well, I gave a couple of our guys last year at States, one of my own Pennsylvania reversible polyesters, and the Keystones. They had the Keystone right here.
Gotta love the polyester.
Does Joey wear that at States?
No, I think McLeod.
He's too busy wearing
singlets. And Rylan Ansel wore that singlet.
Freaking 220
or more. Like it was extra small.
Like last year.
Yeah.
I'm
running out of old singles, man. I gave them all away.
Oh. I still got a couple laying around. I need to give them out as far as we get. And I give them shirts and all that stuff away.
About a month ago, I brought in a garbage bag full of t-shirts and stuff. And like, here, guys, yeah. I was like, when do you want these back? Some other year. Yeah, Ferguson. John Ferguson.
What's about them?
My 60 pounder was like, can we keep these? Kurt Angle's
that would be hot. Three teams.
Only if he wears the red swing, you gotta wear the blue.
Yeah, we'll have that match down here in the dining
Cream,
area.
Cream's a season. Swing's a season veteran.
I know.
That's crafty.
He is crafty.
He's crafty.
Yeah.
But it's going to be busy for us all. But you know what? If we didn't love what we do.
Is it really 7:30?
Well, we start an hour late because I thought I had to go to the emergency room to get a drill bit out of my
stomach. Come on, man. You only have one pin, and you may have swallowed something.
Some metal, you know. Oh, yeah. Terrible. Yeah.
That would be a good fundraiser for Vava, don't you think, Swink? It would be like, good body.
And Gary Davis.
Gary Davis is guest referee, like Nikita Koloff. That's Star
Gator. Welcome to my world. It's ever. Welcome. Well, that's about all we got.
That's pretty much it. How long did we go this week?
We went
47 minutes.
A little shorter.
Yeah.
You know.
And jello. The hits keep on coming.
Ring the bell, you pansy.
But hey, hopefully next week we'll be back on our regular scheduled time around 7:30.
5:30.
Now you need a guilt trip Swink to come in because he's going
to
be here next weekend.
June.
Well, you better bring the singlet.
Yeah. June.
Don't let him.
You owe us.
What are y'all doing next week?
You got the training kit.
It's Saturday, Sunday, right?
Yeah.
No, Friday.
Oh, the 13th, I have graduation.
Oh, actually, Bill will probably come out Saturday morning. But
yeah. We got sunny clothes on here, man.
Maybe sunny on there.
Yeah.
So you can yell at me.
We got Raglan coming in.
We'll get Mr. Raglan.
Mr. Rags. I don't know.
If it gets sunny in here, he's going to yell at me.
No, he did yell at you.
He did yell at me.
You know, but yeah, a lot of good stuff happened in the state of Virginia.
You got to give a shout out. You need to give a shout out to this guy. I'll give a shout out to Gary Davis.
By the way, Swink, I'm really sorry I cursed. I really feel bad.
Don't apologize. But you do need to give a shout out to those guys. We were on a conference call the other night. It's good to have the communication. We're starting to get things going.
It's going really well.
Numbers are up, so you want to keep it going, and things are looking good.
One of the best things I've seen just recently was the Mac.com put a little article about Andrew Bearer.
Getting the job in Virginia.
Huge.
You don't
know
Bear,
he's a great guy.
Yeah.
He's
a
very personable, knows
the
great networker,
he's
gonna take Virginia
Wrestling
on the next level. I mean, he is.
It's
all good. I love it, man.
All right.
Good stuff.
Hey, my shout out is to Lewis and Clark. Way to go and travel the country before it was a country in 1804. Nice work, gentlemen. That's my shout-out.
Up and out. Who did they help out for first?
Jefferson. Just had the Louisiana Purchase. Jefferson said, hey, what the hell's
out
there? Go check it out.
Mine's actually a little different. My shout-out tonight is to Mr. Sears and Mr. Martin, who are the security guys at Meadowbrook High School, who have been running nonstop the last week because we're doing that, finishing up SOLs and seniors getting to graduate. These guys are all over the place. Now, Mr. Martin is a corrections officer, so he's they call him Top Flight because he's so intense. And Mr. Sears, we've pulled on halfway through the year, and he's just as intense. Man, these guys are doing a great job running kids to class and getting the right spot.
Yeah, that's good.
And they've got the teachers back. When I got to the fight and fell on my face, Sears had had the person down.
You gave up two.
Yeah, I did. Yeah.
It's 2-0.
It's awesome.
2-0 right now. I don't think you got the escape.
I had to injure. I did the
Jersey Tornado.
My shout out this week is gonna go to a guy in Vawa. You know, he's a youth guy, so he doesn't really get the, you know, I don't see him around. Bill Grubbs. You know, putting together the school board trip.
Yeah.
You know, most of the time those guys, you know, they get a little, their kids get a little older. You know, they kind of step away from it a little bit. They go to the high school scene and stuff. But Bill's there, man. He has an older boy repping. He has his youngest still scrapping at the youth level and stuff, but organized the schoolboy duels trip, organized the training camp with the Governor Robinson.
Yeah, he's doing a great job.
You know, he's a good dude, man. You know, that's my shout out this week for Bill Grubbs.
Hey, and Nathan Broughton just checked in. Nathan, you missed it. We're done, Nate. Yeah, we're done. We did shout outs.
Come on, bro.
Okay, but we'll give
come
you
on, Nate.
We'll give you a shout out though. I mean, the guy's working, you know.
Phenomenal guy.
You gotta give a shout out to Nate Broughton. You gotta give a shout out to Nate Broughton for getting down to Richmond, bringing his little guys down.
Yeah.
And working with DT Bagley.
Come on the show, Broughton.
You know, working with DT Bagley.
Yeah.
Thanks, Nate. And you gotta give a shout out to these three studs for even letting anyone on the show.
Especially you.
Because it ruins your street cred.
And it's just been a hell of a Friday night, guys.
Yeah, there you go.
We'll get something to eat after this once we break down.
I am really hungry.
Hey, fellas, let's get a breakdown.
Hey, Jordanism of the week.
Gordonism of the week. I know, it's like you put me on the spot.
It's overrated.
At one of the very first tournaments that he was at, I think it was the Hope Bowl Classic when he was head coach. I tried to tell him, like, coach, you gotta understand, Virginia, and I think I told you the same thing, you gotta understand, Virginia officials in high school are all over the place. Some are good, some are bad. I said, but most of the guys here are not very good. And he got mad at the official, and he did it kind of in a passive-aggressive way. And then the corner's like, do you know who I am? I got more juice than all you guys combined. And I'm like, just sitting there like,
what do you mean by juice?
We have a little running joke between us that we really can't say on air, but it's pretty funny. But we love Coach Gordon, what he's done for
the Showed up last week. I made fun of him about Jacobs Field.
He did come to the Vawa State.
By the way, it's no longer Jacobs Field, so you need guys at St. Chris. That's okay.
All right, whatever, dude. All
right.
Yes, Brock, you're too late catching the show. The delay, I know, I'm sorry. But I'll post this up on YouTube probably later tonight or tomorrow.
We're sorry, Broughton.
Yeah, but you gotta watch the beginning. It explains itself, alright?
Yeah, it is quite revealing.
So, from all of us to all of you, have a good Shabbos, good Friday night.
Have a good week, everybody.
And we'll catch you later on Talkin' Wrestling.